WBAL News Now and the big story of the day on WBAL News Radio 1090. FM 101.5 and the WBAL mobile app.
The impeachment event will be televised. It has gone live. It has taken a new step with the resolution passed in the House yesterday to go public with the impeachment hearings, though Republicans don't think it's necessarily entirely fair still. But the vote yesterday to move on with the impeachment inquiry talk and ultimately lead to a vote on impeachment, because that's what it was yesterday, 231 to 194 on party lines. There were a couple of Democrats, two Democrats who voted against it. Not one Republican voted for it, though Justin Amash, who used to be a Republican, used to be in the Freedom Caucus, who is now an independent, did vote in favor of moving forward with public hearings on impeachment and ultimately getting a vote on impeachment. So it is a deadlock, essentially, between Republicans and Democrats on this. And this is the story to me more than anything else. The story of Washington, the story of the country, for that matter, and is likely good news for the president when you think about it that way, because all of the Republicans in the House, and it seems like most in the Senate as well, have circled the wagons and they are supporting the president of the United States. They are supporting the leader of their party. And that has to be looked down as good news for the president when it comes to impeachment. I mean, look, the strong odds. What are we talking about here? What's going to happen? Strong odds that the president will be impeached and that he will be acquitted by the Senate. He'll be impeached, will not be removed from office, and then he'll run for re-election in 2020. I have to say I laughed a little bit yesterday flipping around the cable channels and listening how far the chasm is between Democrats and Republicans right now. And it's just unbelievable. I think that's where the country is, too. But here's Nancy Pelosi, to give you an example. Here's Nancy Pelosi talking about what it's all about and when where they're going.
This isn't about anything personal with the president. It isn't about politics. It isn't about partisanship. It's about patriotism.
Patriotism, okay. Steve Scalise, Republican, says, no, it's not about patriotism. In fact, it's kind of Soviet-esque.
When you see that not only did every single Republican reject the Soviet-style impeachment process, but we were even joined by Democrats who couldn't stand it anymore.
Soviet-style, all right? Patriotism, Soviet-style. Nancy Pelosi on what they're after.
It's about the truth, and it's about the Constitution, and we're working hard to defend our democracy.
Devin Nunes, Republican from California, congressman, on how they were after this from day one.
Every one of their actions, from the staff they hire to the Trump conspiracy theories they investigate, their willful neglect of our basic oversight duties, demonstrates that this has been their plan from day one.
All right. And then you have Adam Schiff, Democrat, on what this means for the country. This one is the most interesting and the one I think you have to say raises a little bit of eyebrows. We'll play Adam Schiff first, then the rebuttal from Tucker Carlson on this.
We take no joy in having to move down this road and proceed with the impeachment inquiry. But neither do we shrink from it.
Not a happy day. Not a happy day from Adam Schiff, the Democrat. Tucker Carlson doesn't quite agree. Listen to how he described last night Adam Schiff and how excited he actually is about this on his Fox show.
Schiff has spent years obsessing over impeachment like it was a young Jodie Foster. Colleagues say he has pictures of impeachment taped to the walls of his bedroom. He is believed to have written it steamy, unhinged letters using his own body fluids. So for Schiff, today's vote was thrilling in ways that only a court-appointed psychiatrist could fully appreciate.
Okay, yes, steamy bodily, own bodily fluids at least. So we have that. So again, this is where we are. And Washington mirrors the country. There is a brand new ABC News Washington poll, post-poll, just released like minutes ago, and Americans are split, just like Congress is split. 49% of Americans, according to this poll, say the president should be impeached and removed from office. 47% say he should not. So a 2% difference, and it's about a 2% difference of where we were in the election, with Hillary Clinton getting, you know, more of the popular vote than the president, and the president obviously winning in the Electoral College. So Washington mirrors the country. And guess where Nancy Pelosi was last night? She was on the late night show on CBS talking about impeachment. Where's Donald Trump going today? He's going to Mississippi today to talk about impeachment and other things. Nancy Pelosi talking to her base, Donald Trump talking to his base, and nothing will change in between now and the actual impeachment vote, the acquittal in the Senate, and then ultimately it'll be decided in November of 2020 by the American people.